Hello and welcome to another episode. I am Brian, the Unskilled Commander, and this is Deck Break It Down, where I take one of my decks, break it down into its component parts, call out the key cards in each of those areas, try and give you an idea as to how I built the deck and what I was going for, what the theme of the deck is supposed to be. So let's jump right in. So this deck is Alayla, Artful Provocateur. It's a 2-3 flying death touch lifelink creature. So right off the bat, that's pretty solid for a 2-3. And it costs 4 mana, a white, a blue, and a black, and one other. All in all, that's pretty much a good commander or just a good creature in general. But then you add its two effects. Other creatures you control with flying get +1/+0. And whenever you cast an artifact or enchantment spell, you create a 1-1 flying fairy creature token. A blue flying fairy creature token. So all you gotta do is play some enchantments, play some artifacts, you make a little army of 1-1s, but she buffs them to 2-1s, and then you can go from there and how you want to build the deck. So starting off, we've got 36 lands. Nothing special to call out in the lands, it's just the best I could do with my budget and what I already had in terms of balancing all three of those colors, and trying to have as many options as possible as quickly as you can, so that you can get her out on turn 4, as she should be, maybe even turn 3 if you're lucky enough to get like a decent mana rock out early. Moving on to enchantments, we have 4 of them. They're all basically buffs with a little card draw. So we've got things like Inspiring Leader, Favorable Winds, and Glorious Anthem, all of which buff creatures. Inspiring Leader buffs your creature tokens, +2/+2, and the other ones buff Glorious Anthem buffs everything, and Favorable Winds buffs flying. But since they're all flying fairies to begin with, and most of them are going to be tokens, you're getting all kinds of buffs from that. Finally, you have a little bit token generation with Bitter Blossoms, so at your upkeep, you lose a life, and you make a little fairy. It's a black fairy, but it's still a 1-1, and it's still a flyer, so it gets all of those buffs as well. So I said card draw, that was wrong, that's not card draw. Moving on to instances, we've got 9 of those. Basically, it's your standard stuff. It's your answers and some card draw. So you've got, as you can see, Artificer's Epiphany, Demon's Due, and then you've got those draw you cards, Hideous End, Leadership Vacuum, Path to Exile, all those kind of things that just get rid of creatures to try and buy you time to get your token generation going and sweeping it in the air for a bunch of damage. Next up, we've got our sorceries. We only have 3 of those, focusing mainly on board wipes and a little tiny bit of card draw. We got Kindred, Dominance, and Merciless Eviction, 2 solid board wipes that can wipe. Merciless Eviction can wipe pretty much anything you're having problems with. And Kindred, Dominance is great because you can declare fairies and destroy everything except for your board state. And then Thoughtcast is in there just to try and draw you some cards because you're going to have a ton of artifacts in the field, so the artifact affinity is really good. The final two categories is where the bulk of the cards are. We've got artifacts, and there's 22 of those. Now, as Alayla said, she's all about artifacts and enchantments. Now, I told you I only have 4 enchantments. That's why everything else is in artifacts. I actually have a friend who also has an Alayla deck, and he focused all on enchantments. So it was really fitting that I just naturally went to artifacts instead, so we... It's the same deck, same premise, but different styles and different ways of doing it. My artifacts focus very heavily on lots of rocks, trying to fix the manas that the lands may be lacking in, and just getting a lot of mana out there so that you can cast a lot of spells, recasting Alayla a couple times, which you're probably going to have to do, along with creature buffs, and we do have one infinite combo in the deck tied to the creatures, which is Time Sieve. So Time Sieve, tap it, sacrifice 5 artifacts, take an extra turn after this one. That ties into Thopter Assembly, which is one of the creatures, so you can bounce Thopter Assembly, make 5 Thopters, sacrifice them to take an extra turn, do it in the right order, recasting Thopter Assembly every time, and you're able to start making a massive board state because you just take turn after turn, drawing your cards, playing whatever you need to buff, and in every turn, the tokens you already made are now able to attack. But otherwise, besides Time Sieve, you got all of your, you know, Arcane Signet, Bonner's Ornament, Soul Ring, blah, 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 very obvious, very, and more of them. So every three and even some four drop mana rocks are in here, mainly to play an artifact to trigger to make a fairy. But as I said, the artifacts do have purpose, as in gaining you mana. Then there's a couple, you know, one or two little buffs like Sphere of Heliod, which gets you +1/+1. Heraldic Banner, creatures of the chosen type, or chosen color rather, get +1/+0. Now that way you can just choose blue, because most of your token fairies are going to be blue off of Valayla. Although you will have black fairies as well off of Bitter Blossom, but you're probably going to have more blue. So again, the artifacts aren't crazy impressive. It's just, like I said, a lot of rocks to try and fix the mana problems in a four or three color deck, and just have lots of mana available to cast a bunch of creatures and or spells and or recasting Alayla 2, 3, 4 times because she's going to be a major target and get blown up quite a bit. Finally, we've got creatures. As I said, one of the key creatures is Thopter Assembly that ties in with Time Sieve, but the rest of the creatures are about helping Alayla do her thing. We've got buffs like Empyrean Eagle, Glen Eldra Liege. Those give buffs to your creatures. Then you've got Ethereum Sculptor, Foundry Inspector, which lower the cost of your artifacts so that you can drop them even faster. Alloy Myrrh, which gives you, you know, helps mana. A couple other mana dorks in there. You've got a lot of the new fairies that just came out with Wilds of Eldraine. I was able to upgrade Alayla, which was a lot of fun. So you've got Obra, Dreaming Duelist, which every time a fairy enters the battlefield, not cast, enters the battlefield, your opponent loses a life. That's great. You drop three artifacts in one turn. You make three fairy creatures. You just hit every opponent for three damage, and now you've got blockers, attackers, whatever. Tegwell, Duke of Splendor, of course. Other fairies get +1/+1. And whenever a fairy you control dies, you draw a card and you lose a life. So you lose the life, which isn't great, but it's card draw. So if someone blows up even Alayla, because she herself is a fairy, or any of your tokens or something, even board wipes, it still sees everything because it happens instantaneously. It sees all of the fairies getting destroyed. You'll lose a bunch of life, depending on how many fairies you have, but you'll draw a bunch of cards to hopefully replenish your hand in terms of artifacts to recast Alayla, and then dump the artifacts that you just drew. Boom, you're back in the game after one, maybe two turns after a board wipe. And coming back from a board wipe quickly can be very much the key to winning a game. Because normally whoever does the board wipe is either just a blanket Hail Mary just trying to slow the game down, or they have some sort of win in hand, or they're planning to win on the very next turn. So if you can go ahead and restock up your board state in the interim, you have a chance of stopping them. So the reason, and not the reason behind the deck, but the main theme, of course, like I said, is artifacts. I really just put, at the time, every artifact I had, for the most part, in the deck so that I could just play them. And I actually originally chose artifacts more than creatures, and you'll notice, or you'll, that you won't notice because you didn't see them all. But a lot of creatures are artifact creatures. I have Alpine Unicorn, Ornithopter, you know, Pilgrim's Eye, a lot of things like that, and a lot of creatures that are artifacts that do double duty. So Alpine Unicorn is a creature artifacts, so it comes in, it makes a fairy, it's a ground blocker, and you can tap it for one mana of any color. Ornithopter is a zero drop, which is great, so you don't even have to waste mana for it, but it's a 0/2. However, it's an artifact, so it makes a fairy, and because it's flying, it'll get Alayla's buff as well, so it turns into a 1/2 instead of a 0/2. I tried to form the synergy around that kind of stuff, and it's a lot of fun. It has, you know, obvious weakness is board wipe, or any kind of major destruction, because, you know, you go all out and crazy, play every, like, 10 different artifacts over 2 turns. Yeah, you've got a great board state, but one board wipe, and now suddenly you've got one card in hand, and you've got no way to replenish your board in terms of creatures. So that's why with the new fairies that came out from Wilds of Eldraine, I tried to adjust it a little bit. That's why the creatures now actually outnumber the artifacts, but as I said, a lot of the creatures are artifact creatures, so it balances that way. But it's mainly I mainly tried to get more creatures that and more fairies specifically that would help the board state and do things and would synergize well with Alayla and the other tokens. So if something does happen, you know, I'm at least playing more creatures and until I can find more artifacts, or, you know, if all the artifacts are gone, I might be running out, but I can still play some creatures. So there you go. It's my Alayla deck. I actually enjoy playing this deck a lot because it's so much fun to just, okay, I play a card, makes a fairy, play a card, makes a fairy, play a card, makes a fairy. And, you know, everything you every mana cost you do basically is doubled because you get two effects out of it. You get whatever you're casting, and you get a fairy. So it's a lot of fun, and it can get crazy quickly if you get the right cards in the right order, which, let's be honest, everyone says that, but that's every single deck. Every deck can get crazy for the most part if you get the right cards in the right order. I mean, how stupid is that? Of course they can't. But you get the idea is that, you know, Alayla can be pretty quick in terms of getting a big board state and a relatively powerful one. 1/1s in the air aren't that big of a deal, but with her buff and then at least one or two other buffs on the field, you've now got four somethings, four threes, four twos, whatever, in the air. And if you've got like five or more of them, that's half somebody's life total. So you can become a threat pretty quickly. I hope you enjoyed the deck break it down. Hope you saw some cards maybe you want to do. Maybe you've got an Alayla deck of your own. How do you run it? Do you all enchantments, all artifacts? Do you do both? You know, would you put away more artifact or enchantments in here and take out a bunch of the artifacts? How would you run it? But anyway, thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time.